surprised Filipinos when he dropped by unannounced during the colorful Fun Philippines festivities held recently in Toronto. Trudeau personally extended his greetings and expressed his support for the Filipino community in Canada.
Our ability to come together and celebrate the Philippines, all the cultures and foods and languages that come together to enrich our country so significantly, to celebrate all the hardworking Filipino Canadians who are there every day.
Hello, how are you? Welcome back to my channel. And welcome to Hangout.
Migration to North America began with Philippine-made ships crossing the Pacific Ocean during the Manila galleon trade. As early as 1565, Spain began sending vessels northeast from the Philippines, riding the Carocio Current in a sweeping circular route across the northern part of the Pacific. Filipino servants, stowaways, and mariners arrived in parts of the west coast of North America, from what is now Mexico to as far north as Alaska. By late 1700, Manila men were recruited in naval operations aboard the ship San Carlos el Filipino, sent to support the short-lived Spanish settlement of Santa Cruz de Nuca and Fort San Miguel, Nuca Island, off the coast of Vancouver. Canada's earliest documented Filipinos coincided with North America's first wave of Asian immigration in the 1800s. At least 9 male Filipino sailors, aged 24 to 42, appeared on the 1881 census of British Columbia. Living on a vessel in New Westminster, they were recorded ethno-racially as Malay, a loose term to describe Austronesian people, and listed as Mahometan, an archaic term for Muslim. A small Filipino community resided in Bowen Island, British Columbia in the 1880s. They probably engaged in both fishing and farming. It included Fernando Torrienya, a fisherman who came to Canada from the Philippines in 1886 at the age of 20 years old with his First Nations partner, Mary Marie Adams. Others included Ben Flores, who were beachcombers and fishermen and were settled on a barge in Snug Cove. Basinto Payson II, who called his home Payson II Ranch and died in February 1904, John Delmond, and Jose Garcia. Several others worked as loggers, millhand, mine laborers, and longshoremen, intermarrying with indigenous peoples and other Pacific Islanders. By the turn of the century, there was a significant number of Filipinos who were naturalized as Canadians or were U.S. nationals in the Lower Mainland region of British Columbia. Larger numbers of Filipinos migrated to Canada in the 1930s. In 1950, 10 Filipinos were recorded in Manitoba. The first-generation Filipino Canadians were mainly women who worked as nurses and teachers and in the health sector. These first Filipinos came from the United States to renew their visas after they had expired in the hope of returning to the U.S. Most of them returned, but some stayed in Canada. From 1946 to 1964, the total number of Filipinos in Canada was 770. In the 1960s, Canada recruited more professionals, mostly from the United States, with some coming directly from the Philippines. Most of the nurses, technicians, office workers, and doctors arrived in Winnipeg, Manitoba. In the late 1960s, more Filipinos came to Winnipeg to work in the garment industry. During the 1970s, most Filipinos came directly from the Philippines to Winnipeg to work in clerical, sales, and manufacturing fields. In the late 1970s, more Filipinos came to join their relatives who worked in Canada under the Family Reunification Program. More and more Filipinos decided to settle in Ontario, particularly in Toronto, where jobs were prospering. In the 1980s, Canada saw an influx of Filipino contract workers, many who found work as live-in caregivers. Many of the contract workers later became landed immigrants under the Live-in Caregiver Program. During the 1990s, more Filipinos came as families and independents instead of being sponsored by family or being recruited as contract workers. From 1990 onward, there has been a steady flow of Filipinos entering Canada, with about 10,000 to 20,000 coming in every year. According to the 2021 Canadian Census, the Philippines is the third largest source country for immigration to Canada.
Prime Minister Justin Trudeau surprised Filipinos when he dropped by unannounced during the colorful Fun Philippines festivities held recently in Toronto. Trudeau personally extended his greetings and expressed his support for the Filipino community in Canada.
Our ability to come together and celebrate the Philippines, all the cultures and foods and languages that come together to enrich our country so significantly, to celebrate all the hardworking Filipino Canadians who are there every day as small business owners, as community leaders, as frontline health workers.
I love the Philippines.
Yeah.
I want to do karaoke with you guys. I want that.